Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. I'm Jermaine Miro and it's a pleasure to have you here. We are on episode 4 of our Mafia Definitive Edition playthrough. Last episode we got a little bit of action as we torched some of our rivals' cars. Let's see what the Don has on offer for us today. Thank you for tuning in, I hope you enjoy today's episode. Notice we don't get a variety of loading screens. It's the same one every time, but that's fine. It's fine. Doesn't always need to be something fancy.
Those first days in Salieri's bar were
ordinary routine.
I moved crates and delivered messages. The guys busted balls and told stories from the old country. Mostly we just waited. I got to thinking, maybe life in Salieri's crew wasn't gonna get me clipped.
Is this what the mafia life is like on downtime? Everyone just standing around wrestling?
You, Tommy?
Come on, this yeah.
Boss is waiting for you.
Thanks.
Yeah, let's see. What does the boss have in store?
Here he is.
Sorry I'm late.
Take a seat. And it's collection day, boys. So Tommy, you'll drive.
Okay, it's collection day.
The rest. It'll be routine.
Just a handful of
stuff. Let's say ordinary routine was the name of the episode. So maybe this is just like, this is just the run of the mill, nothing interesting.
No problem, boss.
Don't lay hands.
This is the shakedown.
There's no other choice.
With no twists, maybe.
Our clients need to understand that we provide a valuable service. They need to look at you and see Santa Michael. They need to believe you'll protect them.
So let Morella stoop to breaking legs. We're better than that. But the bills still due, and everyone pays up.
We can handle it.
Go see Ralphie about a car.
Okay, boss.
Oh, Vinny said to say he's got something for you, Tom. Head to him first. Probably just wants to tell you some bullshit story about some guy he whacked 20 years ago.
They had Molotovs for us last episode. Let's see what he's got this episode.
Hey, just the guy.
Just the guy.
I saw this, and I thought of you.
Okay, little revolver. Very little revolver. We'll take it.
You ever carried a rat?
Shot him at the fair a couple of times.
Right, that don't count. Pointed at the target over there.
Okay. Left trigger.
Brain all up the walls. Okay. Now show me a reload. I open the chamber and away you go. Not at me, you moron. All right. Last thing needs to be hidden.
Up this holster. That's
good to go.
That's those little things that you just so that you can forget really easily if you don't use them very often.
Thanks, Vincenzo.
Guarantee I'm gonna have to look up how to holster my weapon at some point.
Vincenzo. To you. It's Finny.
So, let's go. What vehicle does Ralph have for us today?
Look, you guys need to be careful today, okay? I spoke to Biff. He said Morello's still bent.
This is the car we just stole in episode 3. One of these, Tommy?
Elbow goes through. Reach inside. Easy.
And in the afternoon to fix the window back up. Watch. And learn.
You're a regular magician, Ralphie.
So left to pick Carlo.
Show me what you can do.
You gotta hold left to pick Carlo.
Okay, car, you got it. Have a good day, fellas.
It's a good start. Car's not starting, bro. You don't. Oh, there we go.
A bakery on Longman Street. You know it?
Yeah, I know it.
Al's late again?
Seems so. That's too bad.
Okay. I feel like if we just drive smooth, we should be okay. Leave the limiter on. I don't think we need to go much faster around town. Definitely keep the cops off our tail from speeding. Having said that, no real reason we can't just open up a little bit. We can keep an eye on the minimap for police.
Okay, this is it. Watch what we do today, Tom. When it goes smooth, it's a breeze. When they put up a fight, sometimes you gotta think on your feet.
Sure.
Just follow my lead.
Where are we going? Okay, in here.
Sam, Polly, how are you?
We're good. How's little Julia?
Ha! So little now.
Got here. Something from the bank. Letter from the bank. Dear Mr. Bertarelli, this letter is notification that you are in default of your obligation to make payments on your agreed loan. This amount has been overdue since July 15, 1930. You have ignored requests to pay this debt. Unless the full amount is received within 2 weeks, I'll have no choice but to instruct this bank to begin the foreclosure process on your home and business. Please act accordingly. Christopher Marcino, manager of Grand Imperial Bank. And that's in October, so this says 3 months overdue.
She's turning into a pain in the ass, just like her grandma.
That's good to hear, Al. Real good. Now, you got any trouble around here? Any punks causing problems?
No. Nothing like that.
Good. So you got the money?
I got it waiting in the back room. I'll...
Tommy will get it. You stay here where we can see you.
It's been real slow this month, Sam. I was worried I wouldn't have enough.
Al, I know you'd never hold out on us, but it's good you worry.
I mean, where's the money?
Hey, lady. I don't know what you're saying, lady. I'll be taking this. Via Dequi to you too, man.
I got it. We'll see you next month, Al. Let us know if you need anything. Anything at all.
Sure will, Sam. Sure will.
And give our best to your mom, huh?
Well, that was nice and easy. Not too much to do on that one.
Okay, next up we got old Eugene's place. Chinese store up on Tallow.
He's not dead yet?
Almost. Heard his nephew's taking over.
Guy who used to run this next place, Tom? His name's not Eugene. Guy's a Chinaman. But it sounds like Eugene. Well, that's what we called him.
Polly slammed his head into the counter back in 27, I think.
Yeah, it was hilarious. After that, no problems at all.
If you look, you can still see the blood. Poor old bastard couldn't
scrub
it out.
I wonder if there'll be blood on the counter. That'd be a nice touch.
We keep some of these guys on our books to remind
okay,
we
got the police on the side street, so he's gonna limit our speed.
But we don't know.
Hey, whoa,
so give him
way there, buddy. Don't know about this song. Where are we going? I thought where that marker was then, I thought I needed to pull over, but it's alright. It's like the size of the marker doesn't change depending on how far
this
away
is
it is or anything like that.
I'll cover this one, Sam.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
Alright, so we wait then. Okay.
He's doing the store on his own?
Yeah, when Polly's built up a little steam, he needs to let it out on his own. She's gotta let him get on with it. It's his way. You can hear it in his voice. Gotta let him lone wolf from time to time. Keeps him happy.
I feel like that's a bad idea. It's like... Wait. Okay.
Yeah, Eugene's nephew ain't having much fun right now. When he's going, Polly don't stop. Once we were putting a squeeze on his tailor over in Holbrook, guy ended up in a wheelchair.
Oh, damn. Polly's not messing around.
Here he comes. He's a fast worker.
Okay.
Drive before the cop show, Tom. Next stop's Bill at the motel. Eugene's nephew's guy's money is ours next week. Put some extra besides.
He doing okay?
He's okay.
How's the shop counter?
Yeah, that's seen some more blood.
How much blood?
And nothing he can't scrub out. Once he's back on his feet.
That was a busy intersection.
Want to come out with us?
Ooh,
again,
Tom? We going out of the city?
Get to hear even more about Chinese nephew guys scrubbing their own
okay.
blood out of shop counters.
Yeah. Well, let's like get rid of the limiter. Hard. Let's open this baby up.
Kind
of
not hard.
I don't know. Comes natural to you guys. Don't see why it can't come natural to me.
So anyone could do this. Me and Polly, we've been working these streets for years. You come in and you think you know it all.
I'm
you
not
think
saying
you know
that,
it?
Sam. Mike.
You've been a day on the job, pal. You haven't seen what we do. You haven't seen how we do it.
Sam, I think you oughta...
No, Polly. This punk thinks he can walk in here like a big shot. I put greasers like him in the ground.
I think you gotta say you're sorry, Tom.
Sam got a bit upset.
Well, I'd say sorry if I couldn't see the bullshit smile you're trying to hide.
You got him, Sam! You got him!
I can smell the crap in your pants from here.
Nah, you
it's
didn't
It's the prank
for
her.
When little Tony first came out with us, I had him on his knees before he knew I was yanking his chain.
Yeah, you did better than him anyways.
Oh, that's a nice view of the city.
Jesus, I hate it out of the city.
This is a bit of a drive out here.
Places. Yeah, but out here, it's worse.
How come there's a place so far out of town on our books?
Out of town's the safest place for deals. The safest place for card games. The safest place for most of the things we do.
We're expecting a big bag of money today. The guy owes.
They're getting 70 miles an hour? Let's go.
Yeah, this place is a real earner. Oftentimes, the places that get you the most dough are the ones most people don't look at twice.
Just recently, the motel's had a new lease of life.
Last stop before Lost Heaven for rum coming up from Cuba.
They drive it this far?
Sure they do. And that's how we can sell it so expensive.
Bill's motel has gotten to be the place where crates get exchanged. Salieri protects it, but he lets the other families use it too.
Even Morello?
To keep the peace? Sure.
Plus it's far enough
away. Okay, so it's like a common...
So long as everyone's making money,
common motel?
No one's gonna rock the boat.
Anyone else starting
it's
to
like
miss
the
side of streets and sidewalks?
Continental from John Wick.
Like, he's not one for anything. Indoors,
no guns, no shooting each other.
City,
this is a gentleman's agreement.
City.
Honor amongst thieves.
Here.
Like when we sit in the field.
What could possibly go wrong with that?
It's always knee deep in shit, and most times it's dark and cold as hell.
That's why it's good we got you now, Tom.
Whatever it'd be like the guys that gave me the beatdown might be here or something.
Finally.
For like a bit of tension.
Wait for us here, Tom.
Okay.
We'll be back in a bit.
No, okay. I just get to wait in the car again. I really am just a driver. No sign can tell me what to do. I don't care if I'm next to a flammable gas.
Tom.
Hey, whoa.
Fuck what? Jesus Christ, Polly.
Tell Salieri
who's this guy?
Out, this place is ours. Capiche? And don't come back. Or you'll end
oh, this
up
ain't
in
good.
Worse shape than your friends.
Get Phil. They're trying to beat information out of him.
I gotta get you to a doctor.
I can wait. Get Sam out of there.
Okay,
Oh, okay. This is our first combat. First, like, gun combat. Okay, find the way into the hotel. Go in the front door? We could. Oh, no, okay. Oh, I give up. Get up there. Who wrecked the motors? Give me a name. Too high. Alright, this guy up here. I wonder if.
Nothing doing.
Take him out. One down. Better go downstairs, but ignore that plate, buddy. What's he looking at?
No action for weeks.
Okay, good. He's coming. Come on, buddy. Where you sleep now. Nice and quiet. Wait. Oh, he's got a bat. Hey, is that my... That's not my gun. Stack them up. Baseball bat, let's go. I wonder how many there are. Get first aid there, but we don't really need it.
Guy's gonna stop that?
They wrecked our motors. You can't let that kind of shit slide.
Way I'm gonna be able to take on three.
He don't know shit.
I was hoping I could like grab him from behind the counter. That would have been good. Hey, where did this guy come from? Hey, come on now. Alright. That didn't go so well. How do you take on three of them from there? And where did that guy come from? There wasn't a fourth. At least we don't have to drive back out of here. see where he went. We get off here?
Checking over there.
All right, so we get a new way. We'll do this differently. I like it. I think we're all downstairs. Is there a guy down there? You're shooting at, buddy. I don't like where I am, though. But can't be many. Oh, saw some feet. Look at that first aid. Hear the footsteps. Where's this other guy come from? Django.
I'm out. Cover me. Move into cover.
Who's shooting?
Get this guy off me.
Oh man, I hate controller. Is that not a headshot? Yeah. Is that it? Oh, I think we got it. Is that first aid only a single use? It is. Damn it. Alright, what do we got on the table here? Roberto Glotti for City Council, 1930. A trusted figure in Lost Heaven. Owner of boatyards and industry, employer to thousands, friend of the city, dutiful father and husband. Oh. Semi-auto pistol, let's go.
Sam, oh, they really went to work on you, buddy.
Christ.
Come on, you'd be all right. You're tough as nails.
Man, that was a little elaborate hit.
The money, Tom.
Oh, catch the bastard.
Where is Sam?
Oh, he's in the car. Okay. All right, we got her
inside.
Okay, left bumper shoots. They got the thing right. I got the better gun. Oh. Which might be a better gun. Ow! Oh, no way. Oh, I'm gonna lose him, aren't I? Come on, Carl, you can do this. Yeah, we're back on track. Search the car wreck. Oh man, we are very low on HP.
That was when I saw the cost. What it meant to be on the inside. I should have took off there and then. But I couldn't go back to being a nobody.
Ooh-wee. That was a good one. That's the end of the chapter. You don't even have to get back. That's just it. Okay. Alright, well, definitely our most action-packed episode so far. In our first death, which is a bit strange. Guy came out of nowhere, but that's fine. Gotta be careful with those gunfights. Aiming is atrocious on controller. So bad at it. But that's alright, we'll pick it up in the next episode, see what happens from here. Surely it's not gonna go real well. Especially with whoever those gangsters were at the motel. That we're trying to take it over. Surely that's not going to end very well. Alright, well, thank you for sticking with us until the end. Check tomorrow's upload for the next episode as we continue on. And we'll see you then. Thanks very much.